Hello and welcome back to my garage. Today we're going to work on the Nissan Almera again. Like I said before, there are some minor issues, and one of these issues is that this car has a sloppy stick. And like everybody knows, no one likes a sloppy stick. Also, I noticed that the car was engaging the clutch was a bit off. It's not the way how I expect it to be. It did feel like that the clutch was worn. What I already did was I adjusted the height of the pedal a little bit, and that really helped. But it is still not really there. So we're going to do two things in this video. One, address the sloppy stick by replacing some bushings. These bushings can be found from third parties, and most of the time, if you can find stuff, a good rule of thumb is if a third party manufacturer is making the part, it is a part that is probably prone to wear. When a part doesn't wear that much, so it doesn't sell that much, it is just not profitable to make the part. So a good rule of thumb again, in this case we have some shifting problems and third parties are making these two things. Well, bet your ass that one of these things is the culprit, or maybe the both of them have a little bit to do with it. But that is just a little tip from me. Of course, if you don't can find it, then go to your dealer and they probably can source you the right parts. So what I did was I found that in this case Verbest parts, never heard of them, makes these two bushings for this car. So these two I have bought. Hopefully these two parts will fix the problem. If not, then the car is getting a blue pill. If not, then of course we have to look a little bit further. But I do think that the most problem is in this little cradle thingy. That is probably the culprit here. But I'm going to replace them both. They were not that expensive, so why not do both? In the second part of the video, I'm going to change the oil of the gearbox. Hopefully it will shift better then. And also what I'm going to do is change the clutch fluid. I opted in this case for, in both cases, for Valvoline. And for the gearbox, I'm going to use 75W80. And for the clutch, DOT 5.1. I know that the car is rated for DOT 3.4, but this is just a direct replacement. Never ever use DOT 5. DOT 5 is a synthetic. You're definitely going to have some problems there. But DOT 5.1, you can mix and match. No problem. You can just throw this in. There are a lot of benefits using 5.1, and that is, it's not that hydroscopic, so it doesn't absorb moisture as much as DOT 3 and 4 does. Also, it is rated for higher temperatures. Now, in this case, it doesn't really matter, but I love using DOT 5.1, especially the hydroscopic factor. In this case is really appealing to me, so that's why I chose for DOT 5.1. And it has nothing to do with surround. So that's what we're going to do. At first we're going to address the sloppy stick. And, and then we're going to do the oil change. So let's get to work. Well, this is what I mean with the sloppy stick. Even if it's in gear, it is just as you can see, there is a lot of play within the gears, and I do think it's not normal. So the first thing what we want to do is remove it. It looked like that the glue is come off,
So what I'm going to do is get a plier and turn this off. Normally you can just turn the knob off. That thing is really on there. Normally they're not that stuck. Well, we have to glue this back together. Let's do it in a moment. Now you can just take out this plastic piece. Normally we have to remove the lighter plug, but it's already undone. These are the insides of the grommet, so. Well, there is some play on it. I will show you better in a moment. We have to take it out of there from the other side anyway. These two bolts right here are connected to the bottom side, and these two, well, to the top side. So we're going to remove this one first. And these are 10. So now we have to take these two out, but we have to do that from the bottom. These are the linkages, and hopefully you can hear. But there's definitely some play on it. This is that donut one. The other one is underneath here, but we have to remove. There are two bolts right here. And these are, if they're an original Japanese, they should be 13 or 14. Well, one side is 14 and the other side is 15. Next up is removing the shield, and it's held in place with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 10mm bolts. Well, this is the beneath side, obviously. What I already noticed is there is one spring right here that helps with return. My first thought, of course, is why isn't there one on the other side? Maybe it's missing, but there is no hole right here. So I think this is by design. Well, here is also a bushing, and that one is looking just fine. It's nice and firm, no sloppiness. So what we need to do is now remove these two bolts, and these are 12. Now we need to do obviously the other side, and we're going to remove the hole so we can take it to the workbench and have a better look. Well, this is a 14. Well, that thing is in there, so you don't have to worry about that. And this one is a 12. That one is dust turn on the top, so. So, a spanner at the top. And that's also a 12. And now we can remove the whole thing.
we're going to have a look at the linkage while this gearbox is draining. Rule number one, always check first if you can open the fill plug. If you want to have a quick laugh, just Google how do I open my fill plug of my transmission, or how do I remove the fill plug of my transmission, or help, I can't open the fill plug of my transmission. It may be a laughing matter, but I've been there. How many people are able to remove the oil? It is draining, of course, and are unable to open the fill plug. Well, then you really have a problem. So always first check if you can open the fill plug. The fill plug is right here. This is the front side of the car. Here's the radiator. So there is the fill plug, and it's a hex 10. And the drain plug is right here. And that's a little bit of a bigger one. I think it's a 12 or something, but I will see in a moment. So first, let's open this. And these can be really stuck. Don't try to just torque that thing open. Yeah, it's already coming. But what I wanted to say is don't torque it open. The chances are that or the tool is slipping, or you're rounding, and in the worst case, you're rounding off the hex that is in there. So just jerk it. And luckily I have a lot of experience in that. Well, problem one solved. Next up, the drain plug. Well, it is a 14, and also these can be really stuck. Well, this one is moving. That stuff always reeks. This stuff is really disgusting. Well, first, the front bushing. And hopefully you can see and hear. There is a lot of play. And the play isn't between the inner bushing and the outer bushing, but between the outer bushing and the linkage itself. So let's change that one first. I am going to use a little bit of silicone paste to help it get it in there. Well, that feels a lot better. There is no play at all. And that is what we want, of course. Next up, we have this linkage. This is something I don't have new bushings for. But there is definitely some play in there. What I'm going to do for now, just cheat a little bit. I'm going to tighten this nut up a little, so it's, well, removes a little bit of slack. But this is something we must keep in mind if it isn't how we want it to be. So in this case, it's a 13. Thank you.
of course I sheared off the bolt, so I put in a new one, and well, it is better, but definitely not gone. So let's have a look at the main problem, and hopefully you can see it. There is a lot of play in there. So I do think that this is our main culprit. So what we need to do is remove two bolts. One right here and the other one right there. So now we can take the top side off. And we have here our bushing. Well, let's clean this up, put some new silicone on there, and well, hopefully this ball isn't worn. Or maybe the new unit compensates for that. That's also a possibility, of course. This is the old one, this is the new one. I don't see any major differences. So a little bit silicone paste on there. Now I can put back this top piece. And bolt it all down again. So, let's have a look. Well, that's almost gone. Well, that is definitely a lot better. I don't see any movement at all. And if there is, it is really, really tiny. So, now we can put it all back underneath the car. Well, most of it is out of there. So now we can just put back the plug. And of course clean it up a little bit. Now of course we can put back our gear linkages. The right way around. Well, so the big washer and then the nut. There's a bolt with a couple of washers on that. That goes from the top. And of course the nut from the bottom. Well, that looks a lot better. Of course, there is a bit of give in that, but it is not play. It is, well, the rubber, of course, that is flexing. But I don't feel any clunking of looseness. Well, next up, the gear lever itself again. Of course, these are those 12 millimeter nuts. It does feel a lot more solid. Of course, the bushings are flexing, but that is quite normal. It's not, there is just no play anymore. Next up, we can put back the shield.
And those are held in place with 10 millimeter nuts. And because I'm going to reuse the gasket again, I'm going to put some sealant on there. Of course, this is specially for exhaust systems. It is probably not necessary. And again, 40 on the one side and 15 on the other side. So we're going to fill it up. Fortunately, you have enough room to get a hose or down here in here, and then with a funnel on the top, you can pour it in there. It will be slow, but it will work. I've got one of these and I will inject it into it directly from beneath. And you just fill it up until it's coming out of the hole. If I'm not mistaken, it's about 2.8 liters. Well, that's about one. I do think it's the last squirt. And it's full. Well, clean it up a little bit. And that was the oil change. Nothing spectacular. Just be sure that you can undo the fill plug first before, well, removing all the oil. Next up, we need to put back these nuts. And these are 10 millimeter. So let's test it out. Well, that is definitely much better. I can at least find the gears in one time. Most of the time, if you want to go to the fourth, you are between the fourth and the two. That is much better. So next up, we can install this thing again. Don't forget to plug in the cigarette lighter, clicking it into place, and well, put back the gear knob. I glued the gear knob, so I will do that later, but I think you can figure that out. Righty tighty, lefty loosey, it will be fine. Well, the last thing, an absolute easy job. Only thing you need is a container and a hose that fits the nipple. What you want to do is crack the nipple. Put your hose on there. Make a little bit of a loop upwards. And then the only thing you want to do is fill the fill plug every time with new oil. So we're going to flush the system. What I could do is pump it in all dry, but that's not what I'm going to do. still not empty.
Well, I take the easy route, I will suck it out. Well, it does look like that all the old oil is gone. So what I'm going to do now is pump again until I don't see any bubbles on this hose anymore. If there are still bubbles, then I'm going to fill it and pump it some more until all the bubbles are gone. Just be sure that you top off the reservoir. To be honest, it looks quite good. So now we don't have any bubbles in the system anymore. We can close the valve again. Have a quick feel. If the pedal feels okay, if not, then rinse and repeat until you get a firm, well, pedal. And here we are a couple of weeks later. No, I didn't forget to make the outro. It was just that I want to drive the car a little bit. And of course, the miss had to, give her opinion as well. Well, she is very happy with the car right now. It drives really good and shifts really good. But to be honest, when I first drove it, it did shift still a little bit stiff. The clutch was sticking, or, well, maybe you know that feeling when a pedal gets a bit of mushy, a little bit sticky. That's the feeling when a clutch goes bad, or, well, it's just worn. And I still did have that little bit of a feeling in it. The feeling is almost gone. So I think that the oil in the gearbox helped a little bit loosening, well, stuff up or something, but it shifts a lot nicer than it did before. The miss finds the shifting 10 times better than it was, and it definitely is, but then again, it is not as tight as I thought it should be. So maybe those other bushings are still a little bit of a culprit. But then again, she is happy, it's her car, she has to drive it, so it's all fine by me. But yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, or at least learned something from it. And if you did, please give it a like. If you want to follow me around, you know what to do, and I will see you next time. Bye. If I had three, I could juggle, but meh.